Okay, folks, well, here it is. This is the review of the Supernatural 67 Chevy Impala Sports Sedan by AMT and 125th scale. A lot of people have been waiting for this kit to come out. I know that you've been waiting for this kit to come out if you're watching this review. This is the car from the TV show Supernatural, and it's got some new features on it. They did some retooling of the body, the interior. We got the custom wheels to match the one in the show. Let's take a look at everything that's in the box. We'll start on the opposite side of the table that I normally do. We will see that we've got some bags here of clear window parts. I love the large attachment areas on the glass on this kit. We've got some for the fog lights, for the spotlights. We've got the red tail lights. I love pre-molded tail lights. We've got a small decal sheet here with enough details in white there. We've got the Supernatural logos that they had at the bottom of the trunk if you decide to cut your trunk open. We've got dash gauges, a big lifesaver. We've got different emblems for the dashboard. We've got marker lights. We've got the show license plates. We got Chevy emblems and the 427 emblem right there on that decal sheet for you. We've got some newly tooled chrome parts. Check out that front end. Some black washing, we'll glue the headlights in place. We got handles. We've got the custom wheels. And I double checked and triple checked on the show. I had wheels just like this on my GMC that I put on, American Racing wheels, but mine were brushed aluminum. The ones in the show are chrome, so I will be leaving them alone. I like the look of them as they are. We've got our rear bumper open for those red taillights. We've got our windshield wipers, our rear view mirror. We've got the side mirrors there, and we've got some body trim for under the hood. We've got four tires. I just wanted to show them to you this way. They are big and littles. Make sure you put them on the appropriate end of the car. Nice tread pattern, absolutely no brand name. No sponsors were going to pay for the tires in the show. So those look real nice, and then these are the wider ones for the rear. A little bit of a bigger tire. We'll sand those down. We'll make them look realistic. Let me jump to the other side of the desk for the styrene. We've got our front seat, nice bucket seats, seat backs, got that big slab hood. Flip that upside down. You can ride that down the hill and hit Mach 6 in the winter. That hood has more square footage than my first apartment. We've got nice interior panels for the four-door. They didn't scrimp and make it a two-door panel and try to hide it. That is very beautiful. Crisply molded. We've got the steering column there. We got what looks like wheel parts there. Let's get some more plastic out here. This is just detailed enough with parts to give you a nice show replica, or, you know, a four-door sports sedan to do what you want, and yet not going overboard on things. We've got our shocks, suspension, steering arms right there. We've got our wheel backs and wheel parts, our axles. We've got our newly tooled back seat. Looks awesome with the trim and a nice texture. You can see that textured package shelf back there. That will be easy to detail paint. We got a sweet looking dual exhaust system on there. We've got our valve covers. Now I'm gonna have to paint those chrome. I did Google Supernatural car engine, so I know the color to paint it, and the manual has call outs for paint as well. And I like to confirm by going on Google every now and then and getting that on a movie vehicle or TV vehicle. We got the nice dash with that texture on top. Nice gauge. If you decide to paint the gauges, it won't be hard. They're very prominent in there. We've got our firewall, radiator surround, our fan. We got our big block all ready to go. We got our radiator support and radiator. Nice manifolds on there. Gorgeous heads if you wanted to do a car in construction. You can see inside those. We've got our dual exhaust system here, the rest of it, with the mufflers, the resonators, the differential, the pumpkin cover, the drive shaft. And now let's get it out on the desk, that big body. Before we get to that, we've got our interior. We've got our frame, a separate frame on this one. Nice looking, proper shape. Looks every bit the part. We have our interior pan and our chassis here. You can see the interior pan will make doing up our interior much easier. all looks good. And let's check out that four-door body, newly tooled. Nice seam lines. All the door seams stick out. We got our handles molded in. Looks very nice to me. We got our inner fenders all together in one. We got locating areas for those windshield wipers. Nothing for the mirrors or the spotlights, but we can remedy that. Super glue will be used to attach those. Nice molding on the side of the body. That's nice and prominent. So we can get our chrome paint, our Molotow pen, or our silver Sharpie around all the molding. Nice looking. We can cut that trunk open if we desire and have a nice opening trunk. Just have to scribe and scribe and scribe and work at it. But you'd be able to open that up if so desired. Yeah, that's a nice looking body. So I'm going to get building the Supernatural Impala. I'm going to do it as the show for this review. Build it right out of the box as it appears on the box top. I'll be right back with some sub-assemblies. What time is it?
It's sub-assembly time.
Yeah, we got things all cut apart. We got stuff assembled. Now let's talk about the body very first of all. On the body, it says, check hood fit in this step, sanding down the radiator crossmember as needed. That crossmember across the top. So then they know that there is a slight fit issue with the height of the hood across the radiator crossmember. Now I have sanded mine down just using a sanding stick, and I've got a good fit. Rubbing my fingers across there, I can feel that it's even or even enough. All it did was take some sanding. You can see where it's rougher there. I just sanded it back and forth with a sanding stick and brought the height of that down until the hood sits at a nice level. Very nice, easy step. And if you were to notice that without seeing it in the instructions, just go ahead and work on it on your own. I've got the firewall glued in place. I've got the steering shaft and the master cylinder. You know what? We know that I love easy peasy fun model building, and I like stuff molded in plastic. Now this is pretty smooth. I mean, we can see a shine across that plastic. So what I'm going to try to do is I'm just going to try to clear coat that black plastic. The car is black. It's a very glossy black. I'm going to try to leave it as it is, run a couple coats of future floor polish brushed over it, and see what I get. So, and if it doesn't work, it's really easy. I can soak the body in future and super clean, purple super clean, scrub it clean, spray it, paint it, we'll be all set. But we're going to try it my way first before we get done. Now I've got the frame and it's just pushed on, so we can see that it fits lovely and looks great on there. The fit is not a problem. We'll pull it off. This doesn't need any work at all. We can just go ahead and start painting this, messing around with this. We've got our whole frame and suspension and driveline installed in one. That is a nice assembly. We've got lower control arms, upper control arms. We've got the link across here. We've got two shocks to hold it up, and everything lines up. I measured it, cross measured it against the back to make sure we had everything straight. So hopefully that will line up. Our front suspension, it looks like it's a little complicated, but it is not at all. We've got a steering arm. We've got a sway bar link. We've got upper and lower A arms. And then we've got our spindles that go in. If you didn't glue everything together, the front wheels would be steerable on this model, but I'm not doing that, so we're just gonna leave them as is. Glue it tightly in place, and that is ready to go. And that is a nice looking assembly with plenty of detail on there for you and fits the part. Now, all I've done after that pretty much was start cutting stuff apart. Some stuff has more assembly to it. We put the back of the seat on with some glue. The seats are black in the car, but I will be painting them with a semi-gloss. The back seat is black. The package shelf is a tan interior according to the instructions and the pictures I've seen online. So we'll be able to mask that off and paint those as well. The radiator surround is glued together. I will paint this separately and add it to the vehicle in one of the final steps so I can still get that 427 in. The radiator lines and the battery are on their own tree so I can get a little bit of paint on them. The exhaust, this exhaust is on its own tree. This exhaust I will paint with the air cleaner and the valve covers and the carburetor. I want to metallicize all of that on my model. Give them chrome valve covers, air cleaner, do the exhaust up and the carburation all at the same time. The steering column has been glued together, and then that will be painted tan with a black steering wheel. It's got a black foamy surrounding steering wheel. We got our drive shaft separately. I can get a shade of black on that. We got our dashboard here. What's nice about all of this is I love black primer. Don't have to use any of it pretty much unless I want to tone something a different shade of black, but we've already got the black base, so we can paint the dash a nice tan color. And then I will hand paint the black insert, put the gauges in and everything. Gonna be sweet. The interior panels cut free from their trees, already in black plastic, so we just have to do the tan on the inside. The wheel back, since our wheels are chrome, I do glue in the inner wheel part, the inner axle, even though you can leave it if you want the wheels to spin. I do not, so I glued it in. These will be chromed out when I do my other metallics. What else we got going on here? We got the big 427. All glued together except for the valve covers and the carburetor. I did put the distributor on it. We'll be able to spray this Chevy orange and then do our detail painting. This is a used car. It's not a brand new car in the show. It's not 1967 immediately. So the car is used. So I'm going to be doing a little bit of work on stuff, weathering it up just a hair so it's my nice used universe. We got those gorgeous wheels. They're just going to need a little bit of black washing to bring them out, in my opinion. And that's how I want to do it. But otherwise, I am set to go. I will be hand painting in the grill with some black in here, then cleaning it up, then adding our turn signal. You can either do it with Tamiya orange, or you can use the decals provided. Then gluing our headlights in. Obviously, I'm going to use Mod Podge for that. And then we've got our spotlights, which are two pieces each, plus their clear lenses. We'll have to be careful putting those together. So I'm going to get to work on everything and paint. I'll see you over there. Before I wrap the build up and show you the final, let's take a look at everything I've got done and where we are. Check out the awesome chassis on this thing. Looks like the movie car with the tan interior, the tan carpet, and the black seats. Did some basic accents on those door panels with just some silver marker. That looks awesome, and that dashboard came out real nice, hand painting those details and using the decal gauges to hold it down. Don't forget that black rim around the steering wheel. It does have that one of those wraparound naugahyde or whatever you call them, pleather steering wheel wraps. And don't forget the nice little trim piece they give you for the back seat as well. I did a little bit of Tamiya black wash in there just to bring that out. So that is a nice looking chassis. You can see that 427 that the kit has. I decided to go with chrome valve covers and an air cleaner. If you go online, Google Supernatural Impala engine. This seems to be a common picture with the chrome valve covers and stuff, so that's what I went with. But being a TV show, there's numerous different cars, so do it however you like. Paint an engine color, chrome them out, do whatever you would enjoy on there. But everything on that goes together well. We got our radiator lines in. Underneath is a beautiful car. We got that separate frame. That's why I wanted to do them in different tones. We have the semi-gloss on the frame, the flat black on the body. And that looks lovely with the gas tank and the large dual exhausts coming out. That goes together so well. I love it when the exhaust is already designed to go underneath that axle and I can paint it and do it later. You saw in those pictures. So that's a nice looking assembly there. That will definitely pass as the hero car, as the movie car in the show. No issues at all. The wheel and tire package. Yummy, yummy, yummy. Nice. Left it chrome. Mine were brushed aluminum when I had these style with those arrows in them. But you can see that black wash just enhances the chrome enough to look like a real car wheel. Like a car that's driven as well. Because remember, this thing was driven all over. And in the backs, I'm glad that I chromed that paint so that they look nice on the back as well. Instead of just black, that will really let us know that it is the Supernatural Impala. Check out the grille and the headlights. Use my yellow paint. Now the grill's molded open there, so we didn't have to paint it. I used a black Sharpie on the bumper guards, which looks the part and goes on super easy, much easier than painting. And those look nice with the white marker lights on the side, the turn signals, the grill with that black craft paint. That's pretty sweet. The rear bumper is just as cool. I attached the bumper guards on the rear with Mod Podge so that there was absolutely no chance of fogging the chrome. Did white in the center of the reverse lights and then used the tail lights from the back with Mod Podge brushed on, and that looks awesome. And then I painted in black inside around the bumper just like I did on the grill and rubbed it off with a Q-tip. Let that black craft paint dry and that looks spectacular. Really nice looking. Did the bumper guard covers, those little rubber covers, with a black Sharpie. Again, that's going to look great. Those parts just push on. I use super glue to glue the spotlights together. I will cut them free from their tree, touch up any chrome with a silver pen, and then we will glue those to the car. All I have left to glue onto the car for chrome, aside from that, are the windshield wipers and the regular mirrors. We'll get those on. Got our little air cleaner enhanced with a black wash around the edges. That needs a decal. We got our heater hoses that I glossed up with some Future. We'll get those in. We got our battery. I just marked up the terminals with a silver pen. And that's it. We've got our body here with the glass in. You can see how the hood fits. The chrome trim has been super glued onto the hood. From the bottom, it gives you three large holes to glue it on. Just an itty bitty bit of super glue. That body's very dull because there is no clear on it yet at all. I'm going to wait till I'm all done. The whole car is assembled. Then I'm going to clear over the glass and the body and everything twice by brushing on Future floor polish. We got the underhood details done. That looks lovely. We got our chrome trim done. We got our silver trim done. So it's going to look great once it's all together and we get some clear coats on that black plastic. I'm going to do at this point. There is very few decals left to attach. These would have been used on the dash and on the lights. I chose not to. If you open the trunk, don't lose those white decals for the spells underneath the trunk. We got our 427 emblem, and this emblem right here goes in its little shape right on the rear bumper, which is one of the last things I will put on before I clear coat, and then we'll be deciding which license plates we want to use. Almost certainly going to be using the Kansas plates there, the original plates. So I'm going to push it all together. I'll let you know if there's any bad fits or anything, and we'll be right back for the final. And with a little bit of final assembly out of the way, which went pretty well, the body is a tight fit along the frame. You want to put the back in first and lean it down. It's got two points that it glues into along the front fenders, and you will be done. Two coats of future floor polish, and it looks like painted metal. It looks like I actually put a paint coat on the plastic. If you wanted to go even farther with yours and go ahead and buff that plastic and then future floor polish it, it would look even nicer. But I like the way it looks right now. I think it looks great. It looks real, real sweet. So an easy build. 2 days across this one, and I wasn't even working hard over those 2 days. It was very easy. I like the custom wheels, the little spotlights on there. Those are going to be handy for any other kind of build. I attached the spotlights and the side mirrors with little tiny drops of dollar store super glue. It works very well. And then when you put the floor polish on, if there was any fogging, it will remove that immediately for you. It looks every bit the part of Betty on Supernatural. It's going to be a big seller, I think, because everybody wants a four-door. They want to build some basic sedans. This will look sweet as a junkyard find, as just something somebody drives every day. I wanted to do it like the Supernatural car because that's what it was built for. But you folks out there, you can build squad cars, municipal cars, mom and pop's car to go to the grocery store in, grandma's old car that she sold her teenager with a San Francisco or bust sticker on the back window. It doesn't matter. Just build it up and have fun. Those nice lugs on the axles, front and rear, will accommodate just about any kind of wheel and tire combo. You could build a dragster out of it. You could do any. You could build a hometown stock car out of it. Weld it all four doors shut. Head to the demolition derby. Lot of options, especially with that big 427 under the hood. And you could also transplant other different types of motors. The interior looks great. The new door panels, I like those. The back seat in there. The dashboard are all highly detailed, as you saw. These lights on the bumpers on both of those, extremely well detailed. I am really, really pleased with this kit. Those wheels come out with just a little bit of a black wash on them. The mirror attaches. The side mirrors go on easy. The spotlights assemble easy. They're just two parts with just a little bit of super glue and some floor polish to hide the cloudiness from the super glue, and you are set to go. You could also use Mod Podge, white glue, anything you wanted to put those together. You won't have a problem. I am really thankful that round two, as I call them all the time online, round two sent this over for the full review. It came out really well, and I highly recommend the kit. I will put links down in the description where you can get yours, because this kit is out and shipping now. Not every hobby shop has them, but a lot of them do, and the rest will be getting them in extremely soon when their shipments arrive. So snatch these up. I think they're going to be a great seller. You can see how nice and easy it goes together, how nice it looks underneath. I mean, it's just a great kit all around, with a good amount of detail, yet not so in-depth that it's going to ruin your whole weekend and make it a real chore. It just, everything works out on it really nicely. Thanks for watching the workshop. Always build for you. Build the cars you want to see. Show them to me on the HPI Guys Workshop Facebook, and we will see all of you at the next review.